Blog Talk Radio.
This is Stan Bush. I sing Fight to Survive in the movie Bloodsport. You're listening to Justin Ray Harvey.
Chime in and give Jay Ray a call at 818-532-9769. Give Jay Ray a call right now, 818-532-9762. Chime in and give Jay Ray a call at 818-532-9769. Give Jay Ray a call right now, 818-532-9762.
We are live on J Ray Radio. Sorry for the technical difficulties. My guest is not showing up yet. So let me see if I can't find something out. In the meantime, here is some Michael Jackson for you. I think my guest has arrived. Without further ado, Stan Bush. Sorry for the inconvenience, everybody, in the dead air.
How's it going, Justin?
Hey, Stan, how are you doing, my friend?
Oh, pretty good. How are you?
I'm doing good. It's truly, truly an honor to speak with you.
After all the pleasure. The honor's mine. Appreciate the support. How's it been going?
Yeah. It's been going pretty good, Stan. How have you been?
Oh, things are good. Yeah, just writing some new songs and, you know, working towards another album here. So.
Wow. If you don't mind, Stan, for my show, I would like to go back into the past.
Sure.
I would like to know about how you came to... do Fight to Survive and the whole blood sport thing. And I do have a message for you, by the way, actually. Frank Dukes is a good friend of mine and martial arts teacher. He says hello.
Oh, okay. Well, tell him hi for me. Let's see. Back in, I guess it was the late 80s, I was contacted by Paul Herzog, I believe, is the one who contacted me. He was the one who... The composer for the music for Bloodsport and Kickboxer, and basically I was contacted to sing those tracks in those movies. I believe there were three songs in each movie.
You're correct. It was a Fight to Survive, On My Own Alone, and then on the Kickboxer side...
Streets of Siam was the other one, I think, yeah.
Streets of Siam, which is one of my favorites as well. Fight for Love and Never Surrender.
Cool, so, yeah.
So, yeah, I know those very well. And I don't know if you know this, Stan. I'd like to personally tell you real quick that I actually covered All My Own Alone in Fight to Survive.
Really?
So, yeah, so I have my own version of it, so.
Oh, cool. That's great.
But yeah, it's an honor to speak with you. I hope to meet you someday, actually. That would be cool.
Well, I'm sure we will. The world keeps getting smaller, I think.
Yeah, I live in a small town all the way in West Virginia. So.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Out in the country.
Yeah, my brother lives in Virginia. Outside of, not too far from Richmond, so.
Wow.
I don't know how far away that is.
That wouldn't be too far for me to travel, I don't think.
Yeah, yeah. Great.
But yeah, you've had a lot of success, Dan, and I'm a huge fan, and I wanted to say thank you for that wonderful intro.
You got that. Good. I'm glad that works for you. Yeah, it's funny. I listen to that now, and I'm thinking, wow, did I really sing that high? I've always been able to sing high, but that one's really up there.
Yeah. Have you ever done a live version of Fight to Survive, or is it impossible to do? Or
No, I could do it. I trying to remember. I think Fight to Survive was on last year on an episode of, trying to remember, one of the animated shows on Fox. Let's see. Oh, man. I had The Touch was on American Dad, and then there was
mm-hmm.
this other show that, and I can't recall the name of the show now. I'm sorry about that. But I can let you know and find out. But yeah, that we put Fight to Survive up on that show, and so that was nice.
Yeah, it's like I said, it's my personal favorite. I could sing it as I was 3 years old. So, and it's been my theme for life, and Bloodsport's always been my favorite movie, and. I still need to see the Transformers movie, but last night on iTunes I bought Till All Are One, which is a very good song.
Oh, thank you. Yeah,
so.
That one came out really good. They used that in the Transformers game that came out. The War for Cybertron game has Till All Are One is on that game.
Wow.
That's kind of a cool thing. Yeah, Activision, I did the deal with Activision for that. And, of course, The Touch was in the Transformers and was in the movie Bloodsport. Not Bloodsport, I'm sorry, Boogie Nights. Boogie Nights with Mark Wahlberg. And
Kristen. Mm-hmm.
Yep. And it was in on American Dad and on Chuck on NBC. And it was also used for the Transformers video game that came out. They did an ad campaign for it. Oh, and it was on Guitar Hero too, and and Rock Band. So, well, that song's definitely been around for a while. They used it on the World WWE Wrestling just before Christmas. It was on that.
Mhm. Yeah, I'm a big WWE fan, so yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
So.
Yeah, it was a tribute for some wrestler or something. I don't know. Anyway. But, yeah, it's going good.
So,
it's funny how I've always kind of been into the action thing. You know, it just sort of fit for some reason. The Touch kind of started it all off, I think.
Mm-hmm.
And Never Surrender and all those songs. It was like, I like songs that are positive and kind of songs about going for it and all that.
Mm-hmm. I'd like to ask you a question. I don't know if you're aware of this or not, though, but there's two versions of the Bloodsport soundtrack.
Uh-huh.
And on the Germany version that was only released, you don't sing Fight to Survive, which was very disappointing. Do you know the story behind that? Or?
No, I don't, actually.
Wow.
They must have re-recorded it or something. I don't know. Maybe they couldn't get the original version. I remember hearing about the soundtrack because it was done without my permission. and I found out about it later. And of course, you know, it's impossible to for me to track down anybody or whatever, or follow up on any kind of you know, legal issues with it. But anyway, it's just one of those things.
Yeah. Well, I would never sell my version, because I know it's your work, and I just completely redid it out of fun, because it's one of my favorite songs, of course.
Cool.
But,
that's great.
And you know, I like the original version, the touch, and I like the remake that you did of the touch as well.
Oh, thank you.
How did that come about? The remake of
You mean the Sam Seam one?
Yeah.
I don't know. We wanted to try to come up with some sort of modern type of a, you know, it's like the very kind of very contemporary sounding, because we were pitching it for the Transformers live action films, you know, and it was just, it kind of came out. It was a really cool version. We did a video and stuff with it, a music video, and it got sort of mixed reviews, but it was at least it got a lot of hits. You know, a lot of people saw it. Sometimes something that has mixed reviews, at least whether they're saying good or bad things, at least they're talking about it, and so it did create a lot of. Generated a lot of hits.
Definitely. So,
yeah.
I mean, I've listened to a bunch of your songs, but there's a lot that I've not heard yet. But I went through iTunes last night, and you've got a lot of great hits on iTunes. So.
Oh, thank you. It's been going good. I've been blessed, you know. Have had a long career making music, and I suppose that's saying something. It's a tough business.
Yeah, you've got a lot of records done. I mean, a lot, and I'm just happy to do this interview, because I never thought I'd get the opportunity to speak with you, and I appreciate, you know, you coming on my show, you know.
Oh, well, man, thanks for the support. I really appreciate that. Yeah.
Oh, anytime, because, like, you know, like I said, Fight to Survive is just awesome. It's, like, my favorite. And, you know, I can sing Streets of Cyan. I can sing a lot of your songs that was in a lot of movies. So.
Well, that's cool.
So it's, you know, are you considering possibly maybe doing a live version of that song, possibly, or...
Which one?
Version, Fight to Survive.
Oh, I don't know. I could, actually. Like I say, when we did that TV show thing on Fox, you know, the rights to the song, we pretty much worked out the thing with the rights. So, I mean, I actually could put it out now, the original version. So that's not a bad idea. Maybe I should do like a... some kind of greatest hits or something, and include that one.
That would be great, because I've always wanted to see a live version of that done, and you know, I've always wondered what you would think of a live version of that track.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Yeah, that'd be cool. Yeah.
So. Yep. How did you first get started, Stan, like, with your band and everything? Like, how did you first get started with Stan Bush?
Well, let's see, I grew up in Florida, and, you know, coming up through school, I would always, you know, played in nightclubs and things like that. And, you know, when I guess I was probably in my mid-20s, I moved to Colorado to join a band that we got signed after that, and after a couple of years in Colorado, we came to L.A. and put an album out. So that's how I ended up out here in California. And after that band, the band was called Boulder, we put out one album, and then the band kind of broke up, and then I started doing solo records then. This was in the early 80s, so I put out an album on CBS, and then another one, the next album, the second album was the one with the Touch. That was in 86, I think. Yeah, 86, and that was on Scotty Brothers Epic Records. And then I kept making, doing a lot of stuff during the 90s and the, you know, first decade of the 2000s, mostly overseas kind of stuff. And then just, like I say, just things like commercials and films and TV shows and different things. I won an Emmy in 1997 for a TV show, a Song of the Year. So, you know, I've been doing a lot of stuff. I used to sing like Toyota commercials and Coors Beer and a bunch of other stuff as a hired singer.
So basically, you've done it all.
Pretty much. Yep. Yeah, a little of everything. But it's,
yeah, is there anything in your career that you want to do that you haven't done, or?
Well, not too much. I mean, like I say, I've been very fortunate. I think, like, I haven't really had the big breakthrough, you know, worldwide hit. Well, okay, the Touch kind of was, and most people, even if they don't know who Stan Bush is, most people know that song. So I guess, in a way, I kind of have had a hit song, but you know what I'm saying, you know, where you sell a million records, that kind of thing.
Oh,
so,
yeah.
But like I say, it's I think fame can can be a double-edged sword anyway. So
yeah, it's all on how you take it and handle it. You know, great power comes great responsibility.
That's right. Yeah. It's just like I say, you just have to count your blessings. You know, it's that's what it's about at the end of the day.
Yeah, it's. I mean, your guitar stuff is just, it's just amazing, and I've watched a lot of your videos, and see, I was born in 1985, so, you know, I'm like, you know, this is cool, because this guy is from the 80s, you know, and I've watched a lot of your videos, and I'm like, wow, and the live version of Dare, that was awesome. Awesome.
Thank you.
So.
Yeah, that's a great song. I keep in touch with Vince DiCola, you know, and we've written some stuff together and known each other a long time. He lives not too far from me. He's a good guy.
And I got to say, Stan, you and Frank are good guys, too. And, you know, it'd be great to see y'all work on another project again together or something.
Oh, that'd be great.
You and Frank. So.
Yeah, it's, man. So sometime maybe I'll get over that way and perform. You know, I actually did something in Pittsburgh not too long ago. It was in the spring. It was my friend who helps me with my website stuff. He has wrestling promoter. You know, that's what he does. So
mm-hmm.
I performed for an event they had, so that was kind of cool.
Yeah, around my area, I wanted to tell you real quick, around my area, I am the first disabled world wrestling champion. I fought another dude that's disabled, and I'm the first disabled champion, but I don't wrestle anymore because the company went underground.
Oh, so. Okay. Well, that's cool.
So, and tonight, it feels like I'm dreaming, you know, dream the dream, you know, because I'm talking to you, you know, so.
Well, thank you, man. Appreciate that. And again, thanks for the support. Yeah, let me know if you need anything, you know, keep in touch.
Oh, I sure will, you know, and if there's any way that I can help promote, like, new songs or anything or merchandise, I got a lot of people on my networks, too, so.
Well, I appreciate that. Yeah, just I guess just, you know, send them to stanbush.com, and I sure appreciate it.
Yeah, that's a good website, folks. I've seen that website, and that website has a lot. Now, eventually, will iTunes have all of your records? Or to
yeah,
where people can
they
get
mostly
all your
do.
Records?
There's some early stuff that I'm not sure if it's on there, but yeah, it's got most of my stuff. Most of my catalog is on iTunes. There, I have a new, like I say, a big new rock song that's going to be finished next week, and I'm trying to decide whether to put it out as a single or wait, which probably most of this coming of this whole year I'll be spending recording a new album, and then if I wait, then I'll just put it out then. But
and you can get Stan Bush t-shirts and all kinds of things, I think, right?
Yeah, hold on a second, okay.
Okay.
Okay, 1 second.
Oh, hey, I'm not going to go to the gym today, and I'm on the phone with an interview guy, so let me call you back, okay? Yeah, come on by, okay. All right, love you, bye.
Hey, sorry.
Nah,
my son.
That's okay, Stan.
Yeah.
I'm just grateful for your time, brother. I mean, I'm very grateful.
Oh, well, I appreciate the support. Yeah, I should actually get going, but yeah, please, tell anybody they can write me or whatever, and follow the Facebook and Twitter links that are on the stanbush.com site. And once again, thanks a million, and we'll talk to you down the road. Okay.
All right. Thank you for stopping by, and please don't be a stranger. And I hope you come back again sometime on the show, and we'll talk some more about some of your newer albums and stuff.
Okay. Thanks a million. You take care now.
You
all right.
Too.
All right. Bye-bye.
Bye. Ladies and gentlemen, that was Stan Bush. It was a wonderful interview. I'm glad he took the time to speak with me. I'm going to take a commercial break. So without further ado, I'm going to play Michael Jackson, Billie Jean.
everybody. And remember, life is a blood sport. Fight to survive and also show some respect.
This is Stan Bush. I sing Fight to Survive in the movie Bloodsport. You're listening to Justin Ray Harvey.